So what we have discussed in this? We discussed about plateaus. What is plateau? The land which is flat and higher than its surrounding area is known as plateau. Right? And then we discussed that the plateau, it is a rocky area and also called table land. Am I right? Later we discuss about the peninsular plateau. So what I explain about the peninsular plateau? What is peninsula? The land masses which is surrounded by three water bodies is known as peninsula. So can you tell me which three water bodies? That is Arabian Sea, Bay of Bengal and Indian Ocean. Right? This all we have discussed in the last video. And later I explain you about the peninsular plateau. It divides the plateau into two parts. Right? So can you tell me in which two parts it divide? And which river divide the plateau into two parts? River Narmada. And it divide peninsular plateau, it divide into two parts. That is Central Highland and Deccan Plateau. Right? This all we have discussed in the last video. Now, also we discussed that major part of our country is occupied by this plateau. Right? So, let's start. And I explain you about the division of the plateau. That is, it divides into two parts. And the river Narmada, it divides the plateau into two parts. So first is Central Highland and second is Deccan Plateau. So my dear children, today we are going to discuss the first, that is the Central Highland. Got it my children? So let's start. So Central Highland, first we see the location. The Central Highland, it lies to the north of Narmada River. As I told you, Narmada River, it divides the plateau into two parts. So, to the north of Narmada River, central, there is a Central Highland. Got it, my children? And then, we discussed later, this Central Highland are surrounded by many hills. So which are the hills which is surrounding the Central Highland? That is, you can see in the map, Aravalli Hills in the northwest, Vindhya Range in the south and Rajman Hill in the northeast. Understood my dear children? So Central Highland is surrounded by hills, that is Aravalli Hills in the northwest, Vindhya Range in the south, Raj Mahal Hills in the northeast. And also, this Central Highland, it comprises two plateaus. So, which are the two plateaus? That is, first, Malwa Plateau, which is in the northwest. And another is Chotamagpur Plateau, which is in the east. Got it, my children? Here, the river Chambal, Betwa, Son originate in the Central Highland. And this river, they flow to the northward and join Ganga and Yamuna. The main, I explain you about in the northern plains, this small river, they join the big river, that is called tributary. So this river Chambal, Betwa, Son, they flow to the northward and join Ganga and Yamuna. Got it my children? And then afterward, the next river, that is Narmada and Tapi. Narmada and Tapi river originate in the Vindhya Range and they flow to the westward and flow into the Arabian Sea. Understood my dear children? What I talk about the Narmada and Tapi. That Narmada and Tapi, this river originate in the Vindhya range and flow westward into Arabian Sea. Got it? They flow to the Arabian Sea. And the other river, they flow to the northward. Okay. Now, afterward we'll talk about the, as I said, central highland. It divide, compromise the two plateau, that is Malwa Plateau and Chotanagpur Plateau. So let's talk about the Malwa Plateau. Now Malwa Plateau, it is located between Aravalli Hills and Vindhya Range. So in the middle you will see Malwa Plateau. So where it is located? Between Aravalli Hills and Vindhya Range. Got it? And here you will see the black soil, which is quite fertile. And in this soil, the crop which is grown, that is cotton, oilseed, and wheat. Got it, my children? Hope till here you have understood about the Malwa Plateau. So where it is located? Between Aravalli Hills and Vindhya Range. And here the soil, here you will find the black soil, which is quite fertile for growing cotton, oilseed, and wheat. Let us see, here the climate is extremely hot in summer and extremely cold in winter. And here the city which lies here in the Malwa Plateau, that is Ujjain. Got it, my children? Hope you have understood the concept of Malwa Plateau. Now, let's talk about Chotanagpur Plateau. Now, Chotanagpur Plateau, where it is located? To the eastern part of India. Chotanagpur Plateau, it is in the eastern region which covers the large part of Jharkhand, Odisha, West Bengal, Bihar and Chhattisgarh. Now this Chotanagpur Plateau is known as the storehouse of minerals. Why this plateau is known as the storehouse of minerals? Because this region is rich in minerals. So minerals such as coal, iron ore, bauxite, mica, etc. Now, some of the coal mining you will find, in the place Zaria, Bukaro, and Ranigunj. Understood, my children? So, what I talk about the Chotanagpur Plateau, where it is located? It is located to the eastern region of India. And which states it covers? It covers a state like Jharkhand, Odisha, West Bengal, Bihar and Chhattisgarh. And what I talk about the Chotanagpur Plateau? That this plateau is known as the storehouse of minerals. It is very rich in the minerals. So which mineral found over here? That is coal, iron ore, iron ore, bauxite and mica. Okay? Understood, my dear children? Hope you have understood the concept of Central Highland. Now in the next video, we are going to learn about the Deccan